Come on. We can't stay here.
Hang on. I need a minute.
Okay.
Shit. Hello, Bigby. I hoped you'd come to your senses. Crooked Man's the one you want. But of course, you're too much of an idiot to see that. Or maybe you just like me too much to let me go.
I'm gonna rip you to fucking pieces.
Go on, then.
Please, Sheriff. Haven't you done enough? Look at him. He's dying.
I'll kill you too if I have to.
Go ahead. It isn't his fault.
He's a murderer. Faith and Lily, he's the reason they're dead.
Look, I know he made a few mistakes. We all have.
What?
He made sure they couldn't talk with those damn ribbons, and then he killed them. You're wearing one yourself. Doesn't that bother you even a little, knowing that man murdered...
Of course it does. Those girls...
So it's all my fucking fault, then. You're gonna throw me to the fucking wolf, too? You know I didn't have a goddamn choice. What the fuck? I did what I had to! You can't fucking blame me for that!
Look, I'm
Sometimes you just have to do what you're told!
Don't give me that bullshit! You're responsible!
Like hell I am. Look, Faith and the others tried to pull a run on us. And as you can imagine, the Crooked Man wasn't too thrilled. But of course, the big boss didn't want to get his fucking hands dirty. So he told me to take care of it. You think I don't know what that means? Either I do what he says or I'm the one getting dealt with. So I fucking killed him. And I'd do it again. Cause it's not my fault. You think that'll help? You still haven't learned, have you? Still the same old fucking moron. Go ahead and kill me then. But it won't bring back Lily or Faith. It won't free your friend Narissa. And I'm just the sap taking the fall for the whole thing. It must be so easy being you. Just come in here and blame me for all this shit. Job's done, right? George is the bad guy. It's all his fucking fault. But what was I supposed to do? You don't know what it's like, Bigby. How could you know?
You murdered Faith and Lily. You put those fucking ribbons around their necks. You had the power to let them go, but you chose not to.
You don't know what the fuck you're talking about. If I freed them... What would you have me do? Kill her?
Geordie, don't.
It was them or Vivian. So you tell me, if freeing Lily meant she had to die... Do you still think I had a fucking choice?
What are you doing?
I told you.
Wait. How is she involved in all this?
This is the original. The girl with the ribbon. I'm sure you've heard the stories. Couldn't take it off, couldn't talk about it. She used her little purple ribbon to make more of them. To keep our girls quiet, to ensure absolute discretion.
You promised you wouldn't.
All that magic is connected to this little thing. You remove hers, and the spell's broken. They're all free. But you know what happens to her? The same thing that happened to Faith. So don't you come in here and tell me I fucked up!
What the hell, Georgie? We were supposed to look out for each other. I trusted you!
You can't fucking blame me. You're not innocent here either.
Wait, those were your ribbons? You're in on this? I thought you cared about them.
I do. Of course I do. You have to understand, nobody was supposed to die. When we built this place, it was just a stupid idea. A gimmick. Discretion is our guarantee. That's how it started, anyway. This was supposed to be our place. We were gonna be in charge for once, and nobody would try to control us or use us. That was the point. Then the Crooked Man showed up, and everything just turned to shit.
So, do you get it now? Why I couldn't just... If you still think it's so fucking simple, then you do it. Go right ahead. Kill her, then!
What are you doing? Why should you get to decide? Either of you? You think this is hard for you? My life is such a fucking burden on your conscience. Don't I get a say? It's my life. Like it was either of yours to give up in the first place.
You don't get a choice if you're involved in this.
I know what I've done.
Wait.
I'm sick of everyone thinking that they can just do what they want with my life. I thought it would be different here. But it's all the fucking same.
Vivian, I didn't mean...
Do you think I wanted to be this person? What I did to Faith and Lily? To all of them?
Vivian, wait.
Every day I have to look Gwen and Hans in the eye and pretend I don't care. I have to forget what I've done to them. What I took away from them. I look at Nerissa and I hate myself.
Vivian!
I can't pretend anymore.
What are you doing?
Vivian, don't!
Goodbye,
Vivian!
Georgie.
No! Fuck! No, 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 no! Why'd you have to do that, Vivian? Vivian! Shit!
Just... Jesus.
Vivian, I didn't fucking mean it. I was just... Oh!
Get up. Get up!
Don't think so, Bigby. I'm gonna die here. I think we both know that. Just make sure you give the crooked man the same treatment when you find him. Really fuck him up for me, all right? For both of us.
He's gonna have it worse. Don't worry.
Good. Old foundry by the river. All right? Shepherd Metalworks. He'll be there. Fucking asshole. You wanna finish me off now? Or do you plan to kick me around a little first? Rip my limbs off one by one? That's what you wanna do, right? Shit, stop! Fuck, just stop! At least you're consistent. No more games, all right. We both know how this ends. Just make it quick.
All right, Georgie.
Bigby Wolf.
The Big Bad Wolf. You used to be something. They used to fear you. They'd hide anywhere their small shivering bodies would fit. About time you showed up.
I had to take care of some things first.
Little errand boy. That's nice.
Ah, Bigby. I see you've made it here in one piece. I do apologize, but I have some business to attend to. I leave you in the capable hands of my associate. Come find me when you finish, dear.
Don't worry. This won't take long.
Get out of my way, now. Don't make this worse.
Aw. He doesn't want to play.
I'm sure you'll persuade him.
Wow. What a man. Stealing punches while my back is turned. Didn't your mother ever teach you to fight proper?
Thank you.
Hello, Bigby. You look tired.
Give me one good reason not to rip you apart right now.
This gun holds six...
I won't miss next time.
Before you do anything with me, I thought I should point out a few things. Snow White wants you to bring me back to the woodlands, doesn't she? And that's what I want.
You sure about that?
Yes, I'm quite sure. You will bring me back alive. Look, all I ask for is the chance to speak for myself in front of the community. And I'm sure Miss White would agree that I should be given a fair trial. Can we at least agree on that? I will have a trial.
How about I bring your corpse back to the woodlands instead?
You're not going to kill me.
You'd bet your life on that?
Look, there's no reason for us to be at each other's throats here.
That's funny, coming from a guy pointing a gun at my head.
This is just a precaution. I'm sure you understand. I'm no murderer, Mr. Wolf. I didn't kill those women. And I think you know that. All I'm asking for is a chance to explain my side of the story.
Bullshit! I already talked to Georgie. I know you ordered their deaths.
Mr. Porgy is mistaken, I assure you. I'm a businessman, not a killer.
There's still a lot you have to answer for.
And I will, as long as you agree to my terms. Because I'm not saying another word until I'm brought before the community. And I don't think I'm being unreasonable. If you decide to do something stupid, like murder me, you won't get your answers. But you will have a difficult time explaining yourself to Miss White and the rest of this miserable town. You're often reckless, and I worry you're not thinking of the... Let me ask you an honest question. What do you really care about here? Where this case is concerned, I mean. Do you really want the truth?
This is about justice. I'm the sheriff. I have to do what's right. Two people were murdered.
And you know who did it. Georgie. He's dead, isn't he? My point being, the killer has been dealt with. You've won.
You really think I'm that stupid?
I understand you have an obligation to bring me in. But you can brighten up a little. It's over. So, shall we get going?
Oh, I don't think so. We're not doing this your way.
How unfortunate. I was hoping we'd... What are you gonna do now? Rip me apart like some kind of animal? Killing me here would achieve nothing. And what would Miss White think?
This is it for you! You've said enough!
Where the hell is Bigby?
Oh, come on!
Where is he?
Are you fucking kidding me?
Are we sure he's coming?
Yes, any minute. And then we'll get started. I really appreciate you taking the time. I know it's short notice, but given the circumstances... What have you done?
Oh, God.
Bigby.
Shit.
He killed him. Holy shit.
I didn't think you had it in you, Bigby.
Stop it! You ripped him apart. I told you to bring him back alive.
It's over. Crooked Man is dead.
No shit.
I thought I wanted him gone. But this?
It's terrible.
No, it's not.
What the hell happened? Tell me. Tell me why you did this.
I had to do this. He was a danger to all of us. I couldn't risk bringing him back here unless I removed the threat.
And you felt comfortable making that call on your own?
Look at him.
Oh, God. Would it have been that hard to restrain him? Did you really have to murder the man?
Hang on. It's not murder.
Then what would you call it?
Justice, maybe?
This is not justice! You know it's not.
Why not?
This is Bigby Wolf doing whatever the hell he wants.
I say it is justice, and that's the end of it.
Are you serious?
That is not the end of it.
Well, I think he did the right thing. If this guy killed Faith...
And my sister.
How can we be sure of that? Without a trial, what evidence do we have? We never had anything concrete. That's why we needed him here.
The Crooked Man ordered their deaths. He's behind it.
He ordered it? Well, then who the fuck did it?
Georgie did.
Georgie?
Where's Georgie now? If we bring him in for questioning, we... What? Where is he?
Bigby? Is he still out there?
I killed him. He's dead.
What?
I don't even know what to say to you right now.
Maybe that's not such a bad thing.
You're on board with this?
I don't know. I mean, it's not like the Crooked Man didn't deserve it. And if Georgie killed him...
You think anyone deserves this?
Your job is to keep Fabletown safe. The minute you start abusing your position by attacking people, we betray the trust of this community. And killing those people out there, on your own, without due process, it makes us look like...
Like killers?
How could you do this?
It's just one thing after another.
Look, I'm glad he's fucking dead.
But like this?
You should be thanking me. I took care of the Crooked Man and Georgie. It's all over because of what I did.
I can't believe this. I made myself very clear. This is not okay.
Snow's right. This is disgusting.
Oh, it's much worse than that.
What? Are you guys buddy-buddy with the Crooked Man all of a sudden? What the fuck is wrong with you?
Grant.
Everyone, that's enough. Bigby, I can't protect you without the support of this community. The minute you kill another suspect, or rip out someone's throat in a back alley, I won't be able to stop them from calling for your resignation.
And yours.
If that happens, I can't defend you.
I'd like to see them try. I don't plan on going anywhere.
You keep doing crap like this, and that won't be up to you. Listen. Maybe you were right this time about the Crooked Man, but what happens when you're wrong? The second you make a mistake about someone, I won't watch you become a murderer.
I think it's too late for that.
Then don't. Just keep your nose clean and pretend it never happened. I don't care. I'm not gonna change the way I do things.
Having some personnel issues, Miss White? Can't control your mutt?
Bluebeard, this is hardly the time.
It looks like as long as the wolf thinks you're guilty, he has free rein to murder you in your sleep.
No, that's not how...
Is this what we can expect from now on?
Yeah, you make one mistake and Bigby's gonna rip your head off?
Hey, that's not fair.
Nah, he'll just bat you around for a while. Make sure you get thoroughly fucked up.
You really don't want to tempt me.
Excuse me?
What the hell are you doing?
Jesus, Bigby, what the hell is wrong with you?
Please, the sheriff isn't going
to... You see? The wolf does whatever the hell he wants, and the princess is no better.
Now, hang on a minute.
You don't believe me? They came to my apartment, and then for no earthly reason, she wanted my tree destroyed.
What? Why would you do that?
She was helping people glamour themselves as other fables. We couldn't let that continue.
I can't say I'm fucking surprised.
I am. Snow, how could you do that?
Snow made the wrong call back there. That's why I didn't burn your damn tree.
I had very good reasons for asking you to do that. She was working with Crane and the Crooked Man.
So that makes me a villain?
No, I...
You can pretend it's about law and order, but it's time you stopped lying to yourself. You wanted to get back at me for what Crane did. But that doesn't justify it. You both just act out of your own selfish desires. It doesn't matter what's right. At this point, I'd rather have Crane.
You don't mean that.
At least Crane didn't kick the shit out of everybody.
Or destroy what's ours.
He also earned the position.
Don't start.
You know what? You'd rather have Crane than you fucking deserve him. You fucked up your own lives, dealing with criminals, making your own bad fucking choices. And now you want to blame us for your screwed up situation. I've been trying to fix the mess you made.
How dare you?
Is this how it's gonna be?
You're gonna blame us.
Bigby's right. You people don't know what the fuck you're talking about. Do you seriously think you want Crane back? He was an asshole, and he didn't do shit for any of you. Snow and Bigby found my sister when Crane wouldn't even look.
Yeah, but they only came around when they thought it was Snow White who ate it.
No, they cared about Lily. They care about all of us. Even if they've got a funny way of showing it sometimes.
Thank you, Holly.
Oh, come on, Holly. Maybe Snow gives a fuck, but Bigby? I mean, this I get. But I didn't do shit wrong, and I got tossed around your fucking bar.
That was different, Gren.
Well, they haven't done anything for me. Crooked Man screwed me over, and then this asshole just came by to make it worse.
Everyone, please, just calm down.
We have a right to be heard.
Are you afraid of what we have to say?
This isn't helping.
I'm not Finny.
You know what? Fuck this. We've been through hell trying to keep you all safe. Trying to make you all fucking happy. But all you do is complain. So fuck this!
Where are you going? Bigby?
Hey, Sheriff. Are you gonna come see the truck off? We're leaving for the farm in a few. Thought you might want to. I don't know.
I'll be down in a minute.
Okay. Great.
This fucking line.
Oh. Mr. Wolf, Flycatcher left his keys. I'm sorry, Sheriff. I have to take care of this. We'll talk later, okay?
Good morning, Miss White.
You're late.
Someone's gonna see you, Colin. Oh, Garland! Jesus!
We only have like 5 minutes.
And carry me for fuck's sake! I don't give a shit!
You forgot these.
Oh, thank you. It's been pretty busy around here.
Morning, Sheriff. Nice fucking day. Shit! Just go grab that, would you?
Sorry about all this. I tried to help.
Just why the hell did she have to send me and me boy away, huh? You promised me I'd get another chance, but Miss White said I had to go up to the damn farm anyway. I told her I had the money, but she didn't want to hear it.
Wait, Sheriff Bigby, I have something.
You know, he was up crying all night, poor kid.
Can you give this to Miss White, please? Dad says there's no time to say goodbye, so if you could bring it to her.
What is it?
I couldn't take them all with me, and she said she liked that one the best. It's a willow beetle. That's a big one. They're cool, because when they're little, they have these pouches that squirt juice at you if you touch them.
I'm sure she'll love it.
She said it was pretty.
We're about ready to head out.
What's it like at the farm? I've heard ogres live there, and they eat people in their sleep sometimes.
God, I hope not.
Do we have to go? I want to stay here.
Well, we don't have a choice anymore.
I'm sorry, TJ, but look on the bright side, okay? There's plenty of space to run around, and a nice river nearby so you can swim all you want.
Even in daytime?
Yeah. You don't have to worry about the Mundy seeing you. It'll be nice. Come on. It won't be so bad.
Have you been there before?
No. Some of the animals aren't comfortable around wolves.
So you wouldn't know, would you?
We're all set.
Bye, Mr. Wolf.
Goodbye, TJ.
Hey, Bigby! Where's your friend, Colin? Where's the fucking pig? Right, that's what I thought.
Saying goodbye?
Hi.
Hi.
You're still wearing that thing.
Oh. Yeah. I guess I am. It's not easy to forget. I know it seems like I should be able to. It's just... Listen, I came here because I have to tell you something.
What is it?
It's about what happened to Faith and Lily. I'm not sure where to start. Faith, Lily, and I, we had this plan. We were gonna find a way out. Leave the pudding and pie for good. But then Faith decided to get some leverage. She stole a picture of Crane and Lily together. The minute Faith stole that photo, we had dirt on one of the Crooked Man's allies. If he found out, I had no choice. You have to understand. You've seen how they kept us quiet in that place. Can you imagine the lengths they'd go just to silence someone who had physical evidence?
Narissa, what did you do?
I freaked out, okay? I thought if I came clean to Georgie, he'd get the Crooked Man to leave us alone. We could just forget the whole thing. Maybe try again in a few years.
You what?
So I told him everything. And I begged for mercy for all of us. I didn't want anyone to die over a picture.
So you sold them out?
No. Yes. Georgie promised he'd smooth things over with the Crooked Man. But then... Oh, God.
What happened? Can you tell me anything else?
I don't know what happened. But that night at the club, Georgie came back and told me things had changed. He had to make an example of us. We had committed treason. And while the two of us were sitting there, as he was telling me this, Faith walked in, and I had to watch while Georgie... It was my fault. I sold them out. And she just...
Holy shit. That's...
That night, after Faith, I tried to warn Lily, but she wasn't with her scheduled appointment. So I did the only thing I could do. I left Faith's head at your doorstep.
You?
I walked her over here, and I left her.
So that ring in her mouth, that was you?
Yeah. I couldn't think of any other way to get your attention.
So you started all this?
I just pointed you in the right direction. People like us get forgotten all the time. The Crooked Man was counting on that. When we suffer, we do it in silence. And the world likes it that way. We just fade, like we never existed. I couldn't watch that happen to Faith or Lily. Nobody cares about us. Not really.
It's going to be different now, I promise. Things like that won't happen anymore. Not while I'm around.
You'll make things right. You and Snow.
I don't know. Seems like no matter what I do, it's just not enough for her, or anyone. I just can't win with these people.
I know it might feel that way, but they need you, Bigby. Both of you. You two make a good team. The way you look out for each other.
Snow doesn't really need me.
I'm sure that's not true. After everything you've done for us, maybe they don't want to admit it, but without you, none of this would have happened. You listened when no one else would. You protected your friends, no matter the cost. And you brought justice to this town, finally. If you hadn't killed the Crooked Man back there, he would have just talked his way out of it like he always does. So from where I'm standing, you did the right thing. You've been given this job for a reason. And I left Faith at your doorstep because I knew if anyone stood a chance against the Crooked Man, it was you.
I've been making a lot of mistakes lately.
But you've also done a lot of good. Don't forget that. You've changed this place. For better or worse, Fabletown wouldn't be the same without you. You're not as bad as everyone says you are.
I need to tell you something.
I have to tell you something.
I feel like we've met before.
You're trying to place me.
You like my ribbon?
Do you like it?
Faith wore one too. Would hide her beauty so she could escape his kingdom.
They used to call me the Little
Mermaid. Did Dr. Swinehart ever get back to you about Faith?
He said he wanted to run more tests. I hope you find what you're looking for.
I'll see you around, Wolf.